on. They don't wanna see me go 8th, fam. Got an MU on rotation. Where's Dre? I got patience on the beat, fam. They can never be a pagan on my team. I'm out here crusading, what do you mean? I'm just trying to get paid while I fucking breathe. I'm
in the. Yo, what's going on? It's Kadiata, and you're locked into NVs.
One of South London's amazing talent, but he's from an area in South that isn't really known for its music. No matter, as I'm sure he'll put it on the map for certain. Known for his alternative trap, today I welcome on the show, Kadiata.
Welcome, my brother.
You said?
What are you telling me?
I'm blessed. How are you?
I'm easy.
Yeah? Calm. How's your journey?
Calm still, yeah, little. So,
I see you swag that today.
Yeah,
that,
nah, like, obviously, yeah, you know.
That's been good.
Yeah, man, I'm good still, yeah, just been away and whatnot, you get me? Like,
isolated.
Yeah, exactly, man, just like doing some behind the scenes stuff, you get me? But there's a lot of sick stuff happening, like, in the forefront as well. But
okay.
When it's my time to come in or come in properly, you know what I mean?
How did you get into music?
I was like about 10, 11 years old, and I was like listening to like Eminem and that kind of stuff, you get me? Well, prior to that, I was just listening to just pop music, innit? I found I feel like 90s and pop music and all of that kind of stuff was kind of good at the time. Yeah, obviously, sure. Pop music and now is questionable. But yeah, so first I was listening to like pop music and that, and then when I started hearing like the Eminems and all the DC Fast, I started being like, yo, like one can slightly relate to this stuff. You get me? So it was like Eminem, 50 Cent, all of that. You know the kind of beat ones.
Yeah.
And then like my brother, my older brother, must have introduced me to like. Old school, not old school garage, but like, you know, when garage started dying down, like, so like, well, it started changing even, like, so like, so solid, all of that kind of stuff. And then, but yeah, my brother started showing me stuff like that and like, very, very new grime, like, treading on thin ice, all of that kind of stuff. And I kind of took to it and I was like, yeah, like, if they can do it with English accents, then so can I, you get me? Yeah. So, from there, I was just on a kind of, and a kind of grimy kind of puff.
Yeah.
And then I went left and I went right and I went left and then I found myself again. And now I kind of just, I wouldn't say I'm grime at all, but I kind of blend everything that I've grown up on and everything that I like and just try and put it into one genre really, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Now you've had a lot of support from radio stations, like Westside, Radio One Extra, you know, a couple of names on there, Rinse, Radar. How does it feel, or how did it feel, to hear your song first time on the radio? And do you remember what station it was?
The first time I heard it on the radio?
Yeah, the first time.
You know what? I think... What, are we talking like FM radio or just pirate as well?
FM.
Oh, FM, yeah. Because pirate, that was a long time ago. I do not remember. I think FM, it might have been... It might have been Represent still.
Okay.
I was like in school and
do you remember what song it was?
Probably like some silly little freestyle or something.
Yeah,
because obviously Represent, they put people on it, you get me? So yeah, I was in school and one of the people I used to go to school with said that she had like a place at Represent, you get me, like a little slot. And she was like, oh, do you want to come through to do an interview? And I was like, sweat down. You get me? And then I just went down there and she put me on still.
She put you on?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, you get me, so.
You supported a lot of artists along the way, like Rex, Orange County, Temptress. How was that experience like for you?
You know what, it's like, I feel like it's been good because the people that I've kind of supported isn't necessarily in my world. You know, no one's like, oh, man's very like, man's very like urban, you get me? Obviously, I'm not like fully just urban. I'm urban mixed with a lot of other things.
Yeah.
But I'm not, I wouldn't necessarily put myself in the people that I support as well. Do you get me? So it was a good experience seeing how I can win their fans and I can translate this energy onto them, you get me, and seeing how they receive it and all of that kind of stuff. So,
sick. And obviously, all those kind of supporting things was going towards the late of 2016, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So then 2017 come now.
Mm-hmm.
You're doing Coco.
Yeah.
Down the place.
It's alright.
And then we're all jumping on stage and like security, you're getting mad. Like, are these your people? Tell me, how was that experience for you?
It was sick, man. It was sick. You know what it is? It's like with these with these kind of shows like Burst, like it's a sick opportunity, you get me? That's how you have to take it. But like, the thing is like, because there's so many people coming anyway, just for the night, they know that Burst is just a good night, it's just a good brand to go to and that. So many people come, but they don't always necessarily know the artist, you get me? So you don't know who's there for you and who's there to just get smashed, you know what I mean? But I feel like when I was on there, it was an amazing experience because the way I won people over and the way I had people, even if they didn't come there for me, I had them like, rah, what is going on right now kind of thing, you get me? Because I felt like from the start till the end, like a lot of people started paying more attention and interacting with myself, you get me? So yeah. So it was proper sick, man, you get me? Felt like a dream, man. Proper.
He was living the dream, bro.
Yeah, living the dream.
I think for me now, I want to get a bit of exclusives. So Lunik, if you're watching, ultimately, and I know, what's the whole situation now with you now? Because obviously I saw the blue tick come on your screen. Like, okay, cool. What kind of news can you shed on that? Obviously, are you signed now? Are you still independent?
I'm basically still independent. Obviously I've got like an EP coming out which I signed with a label.
Okay.
Yeah, we got Cobalt. And but apart from that, I'm still independent, I'm still doing my own thing and yeah.
Okay, cool. When can we expect some new music from you? Because don't get me wrong, I love replaying ONDA.
Of course.
Obviously you can have of those tunes, but when can we expect some new music?
New music probably like this month or next month.
Wow.
So it's very much like there. We're just waiting for the red button and then everything just, you get me? So
it's all finished, it's all done.
Yeah, literally.
All right, cool. So aside from that, what would you say is your goals for 2017? What would you like to achieve personally?
In 2017, I don't really like saying my goals and that.
Yeah.
I like writing it down and working towards it, but I don't really like saying
that personal.
Obviously like everyone knows it, man's trying to achieve big things in it. Just in the way that I've been creating my music and the approach I have towards releasing and stuff and my positioning in the game and that, you get me. Everyone knows I'm gonna be onto big things, you get me? But in terms of goals and that, yeah, man, I just take it one step at a time and just write all my goals down and just work towards it. And yeah, so most of last year's goals was achieved. So this year, we're going to push for something crazy.
I'm excited still. Definitely have you back on Westside Radio as well.
Yeah. I'm down.
You play the exclusive music as well.
Of course.
Do you at least have the name for the EP?
Kind of.
Discuss that behind closed doors. Alright, cool. Before you leave, we're going to play a quick game. It's this new game called the Whisper Challenge.
Okay.
Where I play some music in your ears.
Yeah.
And you actually have to guess what I'm pronouncing to you.
wait. Say that again. I'm confused.
I'm going to play some music in your ears. You're going to have some headphones on.
Yeah.
And I'm going to be saying out some words. And you have to guess what the words that I'm trying to say.
Say no.
Yeah?
Say no.
All right. Cool. Alright, we're gonna start this Whisper Challenge now. It's a new game. I'm trying out. Hopefully Kadiata, will be good at this. This one should be fun. You gotta try and speak what I'm saying. You gotta try and say what I'm saying.
Alright.
Fuck. Say anything. Say whatever you think it is.
Wait, do I have to guess the question?
Yeah, you have to guess what I'm saying.
Okay, say it one more time. It sounds like you're saying, do you get pussy or something? it looked like that's what you were saying. I'm good, okay. I have no idea.
Say whatever. Say the first thing that comes to your mind. Say,
are you drunk?
Ed Sheeran. No, next one. D-double-E.
N-W-A.
No, D-double-E.
D-W-E.
Yeah, all right, cool, you got one. Edinburgh. Yeah, cool. Glastonbury. Say whatever comes to your mind. Glastonbury.
Listen.
All right, last one. Seven Sisters.
Yeah. This guy, man, when he does his thing, he's like, he's not saying it properly, fam.
Nah, this has been amazing. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Samuel Eddie. This has been Kadiata. Please check it out, man. Seriously.
Love. See the murder I did, the flow kind of blood. Why did I have to?